be you.
For most people, the idea of going into space is just a remote dream. But here at Space Camp, the dream takes one giant leap closer to becoming a reality. Here, you can spend 5 days training to be an astronaut. But you don't come to Space Camp if you're looking for a relaxed holiday. These kids started work at 7 o'clock this morning, and they'll work through until lights out at 9:30. The camp is right next door to the biggest space museum on Earth. And yes, that is a full-size model of the shuttle. This is called the multi-axis trainer, and it was used by the astronauts training for the early missions. It simulates what it's like to be in a spaceship which is out of control. And the idea was to see if the astronauts can get it back in control. The only trouble was, only one man ever managed it. Neil Armstrong, the first man on the moon. So these days, they've got better ways of training you.
This is the 5 degrees of freedom chair. It's used to simulate weightlessness environment in space. When the astronauts are up there, they can simulate the pitch, just forward and back, side to side, the chair moving forward and backwards for mobility, and the roll.
Well, that gives you an idea of what it's like to be in space, and this is what it's like to walk on the moon. It's called a 1/6G chair because there's 1/6 the gravity of Earth on the moon. Now, there are 3 ways to walk when you're on the moon. You can either bunny hop. You can do a thing they call the slow motion walk. Or you can go sideways. Karen, you're the expert on food here. What exactly is this?
This is a typical meal for one person. What we have here is a beef patty, and then we have some coffee for after dinner. We have grape drink to drink with dinner. We have mashed potatoes, and then for dessert, we have M&Ms.
Now, these don't actually look very edible at the moment.
Well, not actually. What we have to do, these are called rehydratable foods, and we have to add water to them. And we have added water to this one. We put it in this little hole right here, and needle punctures, and water goes inside, and it makes the food not dry. It makes it wet, and then we can eat it. Would you like to try some?
Okay.
Okay. You notice here our silverware and spoon is magnetized down with a magnet because just think in space, there'd be forks floating around and it might be poking your eyes out, so you have to watch
this. Okay, what about this whole tray? Wouldn't that float around?
Oh, it would float around. That's why on the bottom here, if you'll help me, there's straps, and you take those straps and you strap them around your legs, and that keeps the tray nice and sturdy right here. And then you can just float and your lap becomes a table.
Right.
So let's try this and see what we think.
Tastes like normal mashed potato.
Yeah, it's pretty good.
Do the astronauts get to choose what they take up with them?
Yes, in fact, there's a very large menu, and they get to say, well, I think on Monday I'd have this for dinner, like, you know, like maybe a hamburger patty thing, or maybe like some type of french fries, fried potatoes, and they can take up things like some kind of ice cream sundae.
So they can, you can basically have what you want?
Anything you want.
So the next question is, how do they go to the toilet?
Going to the toilet is not that easy if you think about it, because of course you can't have a normal toilet because all the water inside the toilet would go floating out. So it has to be a special suction kind of toilet. And what this toilet is you walk up the toilet and you put your feet and foot restraints and you hang on because action reaction in space, you fly forward. So you have to hang on. You also have to make sure you have a good seal with the seat because if you don't, your waist will come floating out behind you and you'll have to go chasing after it. And then there's a handle, and the handle's in the up position. There's something underneath you called a slinger, and it spins around and it chops up all the solid waste into little bitty pieces. And then they freeze-dry this chopped-up solid waste, just like this food is freeze-dried.
Once you've got used to living in space, you've got to get used to working there. All I've got to do is take this box off the satellite. But every time I try and turn the nut, it stays still and I turn instead. Well, they say the way to get around this is to make sure that you are anchored. And then, it's easy. Here in the training center, you're surrounded by the latest in space technology. But funnily enough, the nearest you'll ever get to experiencing weightlessness is simply by being in water. This team have got to try and replace the equipment box on the side of a spaceship.
All right, Randy. Are you approaching it right now?
I'm approaching it. Trying to loosen the bolts.
Go ahead and go and proceed with removing the far side bolts.
Okay.
Okay, that's great. Go ahead and move on over, and we'll be ready to receive you when you return to the surface.
Days into the course, you get to launch your own rocket. Bit smaller than the real thing, though.
Don't catch it.
The crew, by the way, is a beetle. And with a bit of luck, the beetle nut will be brought back safely by parachute.
I learned a lot of stuff that I never knew, and I thought I knew some stuff about space program, but I learned a lot of new stuff, but I had fun at the same time.
We could have a little more free time because it's all go-go all day, and the most free time you ever get is probably around a half hour to 45 minutes.
If you want to be an astronaut, then it's really where you want to go.
It isn't a place where you would come for a picnic. It isn't an easy camp. It isn't where we play volleyball and ride horses all day long. This is a place where you're studying, you're listening, you're learning, you're actively participating all day from the time you get up until the time you go to bed. It's not a holiday, as you would call it in Britain. It's a learning experience, but it's lots of fun.
Now, this is what everyone's been working all week for, the chance to undertake a simulated shuttle mission. But this isn't just fun. Look at the concentration on the faces.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
Solid rocket ignition and liftoff.
Engine steady, 104%.
During the mission, the instructors give problems to mission control and to the crew in the shuttle simulator.
Okay, it's gone. We got the HTL and the problem solved. Back to the
commander. We've got the fuel cell problem solved.
2 hours and a lot of tension later, they bring the shuttle into land and wait for the verdict.
Okay, very good mission, guys. Very good. Give yourselves a hand.
I want to go. I want to go. And you can get to Space Camp from the UK with PGL Holidays, who organise the holidays there. For further details, write in for your Holiday Fact Pact. You know the address, but I'll give it to you once again. The Holiday Fact Pact, it is, of course, the 815 from Manchester, P.O. Box 815, Manchester, M61SJ. But you'll be delighted to know there is another way of getting there for free, because it is expensive, Martin, isn't it?
Quite expensive to get out there, but it's a brilliant place.
Oh,
but
it looks superb.
With the 815, you can actually get there for free.
Tell me about it.
Fantastic. To launch the competition, we've got to go back to the 20th of July, 1969. It's a historic day for us all, because it's the day that man, in the form of astronaut Neil Armstrong, set foot on the surface of our nearest neighbour in space, the moon.
Has it converged?
Yes.
Okay, all flight controllers, go, no go for landing. Retro.
Go.
Righto.
Go.
Guidance.
Go.
Control.
And,
Delcom.
Control
GNC.
Good.
Go. Egon.
Right,
copy. Surgeon.
Go.
Capcom, we're go for landing.
Eagle, Houston, you're go for landing. Over.
40 feet down, 2.5. Picking up some dust. Great shadow. Contact light. Okay, engine stop.
Eagle has landed. Roger, Tranquility. We copy you on the ground. You got a bunch of guys about to turn blue. We're breathing again. Thanks a lot.
I'm going to step off the limb now. That's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.
Now, the competition is in two parts. The first part, well, Neil Armstrong was the first man to set foot on the moon, but who was the second? Who was the second person to set foot on the surface of the moon? That's the first question. The second question, well, Neil Armstrong said some pretty famous words when he actually stepped onto the moon. It's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind. Now, in your lifetime, it's likely that man will actually land on the surface of Mars. And if you were the first person to land on Mars, what would be your words? What would be your historic words as you stepped out onto the surface of Mars? So, those are the questions to the competition. What about the prizes? Well, the first prize is an all-expenses-paid trip to Space Camp in Florida in America. You'll spend 5 days training to be an astronaut. You'll also spend a couple of days at Disney World and some time at the Everglades, so it really is a superb prize. Second prize, well, there are lots of runners-up prizes, including flight suits like the one I'm wearing, T-shirts, towels, and things like models of the space shuttle. So to enter the competition, you have to answer both parts of those questions. You have to send your answers on a postcard along with your name, your address, your telephone number, and your age to Space Camp Competition, the 815 from Manchester, PO Box 815, Manchester M60 1SJ. And you can find details of the competition in this week's Fast Forward, and there's an article about Space Camp in the Radio Times.